There's a famous line that says, don't just be listeners, be doers. That's it. Doers. The whole world loves the doers. That's what makes the wealth and the winning. Doing, disciplined, emotional action. Another famous line says, faith without action serves no useful purpose. Wow, what a major piece of information. Many people these days are big on affirmations. You have to be very careful of affirmations. Remember, there is a thin line between faith and folly. Here's the best I can give you on affirmation. Affirmation without discipline is the beginning of delusion. And there is nothing worse than delusion. Walking west looking for the sunrise. It's bad. However, affirmation with discipline can bring the most incredible results. But remember, they go together. Make sure you have a game plan to match your wishes. Otherwise, they will always be wishes. It is always easier to think than to do. It is easier to promise than to achieve. It is easier to pretend than to produce. It is easier to plan than to act. I ask you not to do what is easy, but to do what will actually bring you the achievements you seek. Why postpone your better future any longer? Get at it today. Get some new books, make a new plan, set a new goal. Ask some new questions, lock on to a new resolve, make a new effort, and do it all now. Another thing is to ask for God's help, which may sound a little strange. This is not a religious program. My personal word would be that humans are unique, but we could all use a little extra help. Of course, it's a two-way street. I think God will do his part. There is a story about a man who took a rock pile and in 2 years turned it into a fabulous garden, and people came from everywhere to see it. One day a man came by, saw the garden, and thought it was fabulous, but he wanted to make sure the gardener did not take all the credit. He had this deep feeling inside that a lot of people leave God out. So he toured the garden and had a chance to meet the gardener. When he met him, he shook his hand and said, Mr. Gardener, you and the good Lord together have made this beautiful garden. The gardener understood his message and his point, so he said, I think that's true. If it was not for the sunshine and the rain, and the miracle of the seed and the soil and the seasons, there would be no garden at all. But, he said, you know, you should have seen this place a couple of years ago when God had it all by himself. I think that's true. We do play an important part in this challenge called making all we can out of all we have. The best advice I can give you is, if it's easy, do it easy. If it's hard, do it hard. Just get it done. Two of the most powerful words in the language, I will. Benjamin Disraeli once said, nothing can resist a human will that will stake even its existence on the extent of its purpose. Shortly put, I'll do it or die. The man says, I will climb the mountain. They've told me it's too high, it's too far, it's too steep, it's too rocky, it's too difficult. But it's my mountain. I will climb it. Pretty soon you will see me waving from the top or dead on the side because I'm not coming back. Hey, that's powerful. Time and fate and circumstance call a hasty conference, and they all agree. We might as well let John have it. He says he's going to get it or die. Wow, that's it. Resolve. The best definition of resolve I ever heard was from a junior high girl in Foster City, California. I'm talking to the junior high kids, and I asked the question, who can tell me what resolve means? I got several hands. Some were pretty good, but the last one was the best. She said, I think resolve means promising yourself you will never give up. I said, that's it. Best I've heard. Promise yourself you will never give up. I asked the kids, how long should a baby try to learn how to walk? How long would you give the average baby before you shut him off? You say, that's crazy. Any mother in the world would say, my baby is going to keep trying until it learns how to walk. No wonder almost everyone walks. What a magic formula. The until formula. Good question. How long are you going to work to make your dreams of wealth and happiness come true? I suggest the until formula. It's the best. I want to appeal to you right now to go to work. I appeal to you to review your associations with those people around you. I appeal to you to set your goals, to begin the quest for developing yourself, and to embark on a journey leading to your own financial independence by following a well-defined plan. I appeal to you to enjoy your life as you seek to improve it. I give to you my strong appeal to seek knowledge so that your value to yourself and to others might increase. And finally, I appeal to you to discipline yourself for the control and management of the precious commodity of which we are granted only a limited amount, time. Work on all these areas, but by all means, work. This is Jim Rohn giving you my final appeal. Let's do something remarkable.